tell you, why is it that people stare at you the way they do? At first I didn't understand, but I went back and I said to myself, God created me. Therefore, I am. And once I rediscovered who I am, when I walk, you can't help but to look at me. Because I'm walking with God. He's present. I don't have to be for Him to be present. I don't have to be in a temple for Him to be present. No matter where I go, He will be present. You don't have to get on your knees for no man. God already given you all the tools you need. Don't let the world change you. You are men and women of God. You change the world. That is your job. We cannot sit back as women and men, having the world to destroy us and allowing that negative force to play with you, because that's what it does. It plays with you. It dominates your mind. It tells you negative things all day long. It makes you believe that you are a failure, that you are nothing. Makes you believe that you're no good for this world. But let me give you some good news. That's why I'm here. You see, I'm going to show you something today. And yesterday, I should say day before yesterday, as I was meditating, this came to me. I want you to show them who you used to be. And I'm going to show it to you. You see, those of us that proclaim that you are God's ambassador are still having difficulties in your life. That's going to change today. Did you hear me? No, you didn't hear me. I'm going to give you proof. All the problems that you have is because you are allowing it to happen. You are allowing it to happen. All the things that have happened to you as a child, you had no control over it. Do you have control now? Yes, you do. So why are you not using it? Why are you not using the tools that God gave you? Do you think God is going to put you on this earth and not prepare you, knowing what you're coming to? I don't think so. I want to introduce to you a woman that was destroyed by that negative force, mentally and spiritually. And she thought, let me tell you about her, because I know her very well. And I don't care if she gets mad at me, because I'm videotaping. Listen to me. She was destroyed. And do you know why she was destroyed? For the lack of knowledge. She had no clue, none at all, about that. I am that I am. She said it many times. She proclaimed it every time. But she really had no clue. There she is. There she is. And I'll pass it around so you can see her very good. Do you recognize her? Who is she? That's me. This is me now. This woman, when she was born, she embraced everything of this world. That's what she did. Because she had no clue who God is. She listened to man. She listened to everybody but God. She almost died, this woman here. She lost her kidneys. When she went to the hospital, they told her, "You're not going to make it. Your pressure is 297 or 296 over 180. You're not going to make it. The monitor only goes to 300. So here she is, fighting for her life. See how big she is? Swollen, no kidney functions. Until she decided that she was going to really study the Word. She was ill for 9 years. 9. It got to the point where she couldn't walk from here to there, in bed every day. But while she was in bed, she was studying the Word. She was studying the Word. Because she had nowhere else to go. She had nowhere else to go. And that negative force was just telling her, "You're going nowhere." And God is saying, "You didn't have the knowledge. Get it now. That is your weapon. You gotta get the knowledge. Fight. You can do it. Because I gave you the tools." You see, this is what we do. We get on our knees and say, "God, heal me." No. He gave you the tools. Use it. That's why so many of us are so sick for so many years. Because we think it's so easy. "Oh God, please heal me. I have cancer. Here it is, right here." But you don't have the knowledge. You don't know what to do. He gave it to you. Use it. Because that negative force wants to destroy you. You have to fight that. That's what you have to fight. That's why he gave you the armor. He prepared you for these type of crises. But we're not using it. She figured it out. The real Dr. Melinda Harris Barrow, the one that God created, stepped in. She stepped in. And she said, "Enough is enough. I'm coming to save you. I'm coming with the tools that God gave us. Because trust me, I prayed and I prayed and I prayed. And I was getting sicker and sicker sicker. I'm not saying don't pray, but pray with action. Pray with action. You have to pray with the tools that God gave you. And they made it. They made it. God, thank you. I made it. I left her. I left her. And I made it. And I'm saving lives out there. Teaching them. Pray, but with action. I made it. I can stand here today and tell you, I made it. My God, thank you. Because He gave me the tools, and I used them. And I'm saving lives out there. Because I'm telling them, you just can't get on your knees and pray. You got to use the tools God gave you. Now, I had to save my life to save others.